जीवन मुक्ति प्रदम देव परमहंस नित्यानंदा, अ रेयर लिविंग इनकार्नेशन, इज नेम्ड अमंग द वर्ल्ड्स 100 मोस्ट स्पिरिचुअली इन्फ्लुएंशियल पर्सनालिटीज टुडे. परमहंस नित्यानंदा हैज बीन प्लेस्ड अलोंगसाइड दलाई लामा, नेल्सन मंडेला, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam.
Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papa vinashaktam. Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyana loka pradipakam, vande shantam. बंधम नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम आनंद गंध संचारम सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम वंदे
ज्ञान. वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज फ्रॉम अराउंड द वर्ल्ड हु आर सिटिंग विद अस टू क्रिएट द एन इफेक्ट. An experience in effect. Experience and share the in effect. First, I'll answer a question from N Satsang Center, Jayanagar, Bangalore, from Mahesh. Dear Swamiji, towards the end of your morning message today, Thursday, 13th January 2011, you made the NFA happen in the five centers in North America which were connected live on video conference, you raised their kundalini, put them into samadhi, and also made vibhuti come out of the padukas in those centers. My question is, can't the same effect happen to all of us who are watching the morning satsang live every day, sitting individually in our homes from 7:30 a.m. onwards? Is it necessary that we should gather together as a group in one place and watch the morning satsang as a live video conference for the effect to happen in our bodies? For the kundalini awakening, for the levitation, for the samadhi to happen, and for the vibhuti to appear, can't all these happen to all of us sitting individually in our homes and watching the morning satsang live from our homes on NTV, though not via video conference? I eagerly look forward to your response. I'll take this opportunity to explain thoroughly the effect and kundalini awakening, levitation, for all of you. Please understand, I wanted all of you to understand what we are doing. First thing I wanted all of you to understand, it is not hypnotism. I am not hypnotizing you. I am actually de-hypnotizing you. You have been hypnotized as an ordinary human being. Island, just a physical body. I am de-hypnotizing you and making you realize your original state. You are cosmic consciousness. Second thing, I am not showing any magic or miracles. No. Exactly as per the Patanjali's yoga sampradaya, the yogic tradition, the pure samadhi experience, the Kulakundalini experience is being transmitted. Please understand. Yesterday I made it very clear, even during the effect instruction. Let the samadhi experience, as explained by Patanjali, let the Kundalini awakening, as explained by the great master Patanjali, happen in you all. Now again I am insisting, let the great Yoga Vedanta Sampradaya, the Yoga Vedantic experience expressed by Sadashiva, Mahadeva, Patanjali, and great Hatha Yogic masters like Maschendranatha, Goraknatha, the Sannyasa Sampradayas of Shankara, these great Vedantic, Yoga Vedantic traditions, what they speak as Kundalini awakening, what they express and define as the samadhi experience, let that happen in all of you. I am very clear. Please understand. Now I am offering my whole being and everything to all those great masters and say, O masters, whatever you wanted as samadhi experience, O Mahadeva, Shiva, what you wanted to transmit as samadhi experience to the world, O Patanjali, what you wanted to teach through Ashtanga Yoga as samadhi experience to the world, O Maschendranatha, Goraknatha, what you wanted to give it to the world through Hatha Yoga, let that pure yogic samadhi experience, not any diversion, any siddhi, any black magic, no. What you all wanted to transmit to the world as great samadhi experience, only let that happen to all of you. Only let that happen in all of us. Nothing else. Please understand. Now, you will all experience, we will all experience only the pure samadhi experience of those great masters. I am very clear. I offer myself at their feet. Whatever energy expressing through this body, I offer it at their feet, pray to them, and earnestly request them their divine presence, and let there not be any diversion from what they wanted to offer as samadhi to us. Let there not be any side route, perversion, or going in a different direction. What they wanted to do to planet Earth, to human consciousness, let that happen on all of you. Let that happen in all of us. Please understand, I am very clearly invoking their presence. O masters, please be here available with all of us, and what you all wanted, that pure Yoga Vedantic experience, happen in all of us. As the side effect of that experience, all the miracles, all the auspicious miracles happen. Please understand, I am making it again and again very clear, whatever you are all experiencing is pure, authentic, traditional, spiritual Yoga Vedantic Kundalini awakening, and you are all heading directly towards the ultimate samadhi experience, atma jnana, atmanubhuti, enlightenment experience. I am not doing any magic miracle hypnotism. I am doing a clear, authentic, ancient, time-tested, foolproof method of awakening the Kundalini Shakti and leading you all to Samadhi as per the Yoga Vedantic tradition. I am saying now, invoking the presence of all those masters, O Mahadeva, Sadashiva, Patanjali, Maschendranatha, Goraknatha, who all the great masters, I request all those masters to be present here, and let them all bless all of us. Let the pure Yoga Vedantic Samadhi experience and awakening of the Kundalini as they wanted happen in all of us. So the side effect of this experience will only be health, bliss, joy, creativity, prosperity, and all the auspicious things, and the highest conscious experience, enlightenment itself. So please understand, it is no way any black magic or hypnotism or mystical or hysterical or nothing. It is pure spiritual experience. I invoke their presence and I promise upon them, if I am an incarnation, to transmit this pure Yoga Vedantic Samadhi experience to all of you. Let that happen now in all of us. Let that awakening of Kundalini, as described by those great masters, happen in all of us. you will see, let that master's presence fill all of us. When the Kundalini awakening happens, as a side effect of that Kundalini awakening, rocking, swaying, levitation happens. Please understand, sometime levitation did not happen. You may feel your body completely silent, stable, frozen, but deeply empty inside. Even that is Kundalini awakening. For some bodies, it will be levitation. For some bodies, it will be completely peaceful, silent, frozen state. For some bodies, different auspicious things will express. Now, I wanted to define exactly what is happening here. See, here is a body, an incarnation body, who is completely not only awakened, alive, whose body is ready to transmit the Kundalini awakening to anybody just by the mere presence or will. Not even will, just a presence. So anybody sits in the breathing space, presence, the transmission is happening. You may wonder, then how through video satsang it is happening? Understand, master's presence is not limited by space and time. So wherever you are, if you are able to see me, I am able to see you. Immediately the connection happens. And there is another one level of connection. Even if you are not able to see me, I am not able to see you. You just remembering me, or me just remembering you, the presence starts happening and levitation starts happening. For that, a little more maturity is needed from your part. Please understand, the question is all about that only. Can we have the same Kundalini awakening if it is not two-way? You can. Even if I am not seeing you, you can experience Kundalini awakening. But for that, you needed to be little more matured. Means, the ability to enter into my inner space, the transcendental consciousness, is needed for you, which may need little more practice. I tell you, if you have physically come here and attended LEP or this inner awakening, where I started initiating people into the Kundalini awakening and levitation, then if you add that initiation and then go and sit in the satsangs, immediately you will experience, because the initiation has happened. Even if that initiation has not happened, the second priority is sitting live with the yen satsangs, that I am able to see you, you are able to see me. That is the second priority. The third priority is you sitting and watching me live, but I am unable to see you physically. That's the third priority, but you will also start experiencing in few days, the more you fall in tune. And actually, Master's presence is not limited to space and time. Only in the initial level, for the initiation, you need the limitation of space and time. So exactly, when the Kundalini Shakti, your inner potential energy, your bioenergy, inner potential bioenergy, when it is awakened by the Master's presence and blessings, so many auspicious things starts happening in your system. Just yesterday, we received some of the scientific research we did on inner awakening. They say 1300%, 13 times the cell energy, the biocell energy is awakened in human beings during this Kundalini awakening, during this yin effort, please understand, 1300%, 13 times than normal human beings. Second fact they are saying, even the people who did not participate in the process just sat in my presence volunteering. Even on them, 1100% the increase of the energy was shown. Please understand. Two groups they studied. One, people who sat and went through the process, attended, went through all the meditation of samana, yoga, mudra, everything. Second group, we just sat, did not do any process, which was volunteering. Of course, third is the normal human beings. Normal human beings, 100% energy means, the group which sat and went through the process was experiencing 1300%, 13 times more energy awakening, the cell energy, the inner potential energy, bioenergy. And the normal group, the group which was sitting and volunteering, which was not doing any process, had 1100%. Means, the power of presence, master's job is 90%. Only 10% is the process you are doing, is awakening your energy. So, the presence does the 90% job of initiation into the Kundalini experience. That is why I am saying, yesterday, when I said, I am physically feeling connected to those five centers, and the vibhuti will start coming from those five centers, padukas. Immediately in 1 hour I received the photographs. In all those centers, padukas, vibhuti coming. Please understand, when I see you, I can say very clearly, the connection has happened, the quality control, QC pass. When only you are seeing me, connection may be happening, but I cannot be giving, I will not be able to give the guarantee that the effect is already happening. See, the yin effect happens in two levels. One, infectious, just because your neighbor is levitating, your biomemory will pick up. It is good to start, but in that level, transformation itself will not start happening. But levitation, Kundalini awakening is happening only in the flesh level, skin deep. But when I am initiating you, the levitation starts happening in the bone marrow level, in the very being, then the Kundalini awakening will lead to the transformation. Please understand, it will lead to the transformation of your very being. Basically, this Kundalini awakening is expected to lead you to more and more joyful, transformed, blissful character. Otherwise, just jumping, hopping is not going to help you. It will create the highest possible coherence in your brain, which will create health, joy, transformation, and amazing, blissful, creative character in you. That is the essence. That is the purpose of this Kundalini awakening. So the devotee who asked this question from the Jayanagar Satsang Center, please understand, you can experience Kundalini awakening, levitation. Even if I am not seeing you, no doubt, but if I am seeing you, I can ensure that connection has happened, and not only Kundalini awakening, the more and more miracles and Kundalini's expressions can happen, as I said just now. Please understand, these centers which are sitting with me now, which I am able to see, all these centers, now two things will happen. One, from the padukas of your center, vibhuti will start coming. Second, people who are sitting and levitating inside your samana mudra hand, vibhuti will be there. End of the satsang, vibhuti will be there. Take that vibhuti and give it to the people who have come to your center now for healing. They will be healed. Understand? This kind of teleporting I'll be able to do only if two-way connection is possible. Just the kundalini awakening, you may have experience even if it is one way, if you are seeing me. But this teleporting, we will be able to do only if there is a two-way connection. That's one thing. Second, I can see very clearly the connection between you and my body is getting so mature. Within the Shivaratri, scientifically we will prove, we will call the scientific community and prove that teleporting is possible from here. See, actually now vibhuti which is coming from my padukas in your centers now, and the vibhuti happening in your hands now, is actually coming from my table, from this table. It is not created, it is getting teleported. From this table it is reducing and it will be transmitted there. We will prove this to a scientific community. Please understand, I wanted all of you to know two things. One, I am not doing any magic or miracle. I am doing the exact spiritual science as taught by Sadashiva, Maheshwara, Patanjali, Goraknatha, Maschendranatha, Buddha, all these great masters. That is what I am, just before starting this satsang, as I said, I invoke their presence. I promise upon them, let what they wanted to transmit to the world as Kundalini awakening and as Samadhi happen in all of us, so that you are all clear. There is no black magic here. There is no hypnotism here. It is pure, authentic, time-tested, foolproof, thousands of years of Yoga Vedantic traditions, Samadhi experience, Kundalini awakening. This is first. Second thing, now we will make this whole thing scientific. Now, yesterday we tried one process. Process of teleporting vibhuti on padukas. See, on matter. See, padukas have direct connection with me. But fortunately, they do not have logic, independent logic. So making vibhuti happening in them is the first step, very easy. Now, second step I am working is making vibhuti happening in people who has logic but who are willing to surrender on those bodies. Now, the vibhuti will start happening. The third thing, we will call the scientific community who has logic, who are not interested in surrendering. To them we will prove this teleporting is possible based on the Samadhi experience of Yoga Vedantic tradition. The Kundalini awakening does not need any physical nearness or presence. It is beyond space and time. So I'll answer all the points in this question, Mahesh's question. You can experience same Kundalini awakening if you are watching live from your homes on NTV, but for the deeper and deeper mystical connections to happen, like teleporting, deeper samadhi experiences, maybe the two-way connection will be really helpful. So I'll really encourage you guys to gather as group in more and more places and have two-way connection. If you are running our temple, then you can have two-way connection. when you are sitting as group, to land on you intensely in the energy form is very easy for me than one individual. If you are one individual, you are initiated, then it is easy. If you are not directly initiated, if you are sitting as a group, it is very easy for me to land on you all and awaken the Kundalini Shakti. So, first thing, I sincerely request all of you who have not done the inner awakening after I started teaching Kundalini Awakening and Levitation to come and attend one inner awakening. See, if you have done LEP or this inner awakening, 2010 December, okay. If not, come and do one inner awakening. Directly get initiated in Kundalini Awakening and Levitation. That is a great thing. Then, even if you sit alone in your home, you will experience Kundalini Awakening. Today's subject for satsang, niyama. Coherence of life. I wanted to express some of the deep truths to you just now, which I experimented during Pada Puja. You would have seen me making some mudras and creating some intense energy with different groups at different times. I was experimenting the great truth of the Vedic tradition. I'll now reveal some of the important findings which I made just now. First thing, I was trying to keep all the hundreds of trillions of cells of your brain at a time alive, whoever is sitting inside this hall. That's the first thing I tried. Not only I was surprised, I was shocked, and I found it did not take much energy, just a will. I saw the whole group, the whole non-mechanical parts of the brain become alive and awakened. There are few whose Kundalini is awakened and whose body is jumping. I was trying to scan what happens to others whose body doesn't move. I saw very clearly, whether your body moves or not, the non-mechanical parts of the brain becomes alive, awakened. Sometime for some people, through biomemory also, that energy gets released. For some people, the biomemory itself does not release us and it just relaxes. So please understand, today I discovered very clearly, whether your body shakes or not, if you are in this presence, the process which I am doing is happening in your system. Rest assured. That's the first thing. Second thing, I want to tell you how it is happening. First, actually, the energy connection happens with the people whose body is moving in the Kundalini. They only first receive signals. That's the way it was happening, I saw. The next thing, suddenly all the other people who are inside that net, all their brains also just falls into coherence. It's almost like a, if you are taking a fork near a vibrating fork, automatically this fork also starts vibrating in the same frequency. Same way, these bodies which are vibrating in the Kundalini are like vibrating forks. So any body inside that area, circle, suddenly those brains also gets raised to that coherence. Another one important, very funny thing I saw, you will see, now what I am revealing will be proved in next few hours through proper evidences and examples and testimonials. When I was raising the hand to the male side, I could see all over the world the male bodies which are sitting now and connecting with me, all their coherence came in the same frequency and tune with the people who are sitting here. When I was raising the hand in the female side, I saw all the female bodies which are sitting around the world and connecting with me was raised to the same coherence. When I raised both the hands and raised, I saw all the people who are sitting around the world, all of them experiencing intensely the same coherence, the same frequency. The next thing I discovered, if you are having feeling connection, even if you are not physically in this space, wherever you are sitting, the space does not limit you. If this time, wherever you are sitting and trying to connect with me, you fall into that same coherence and your Kundalini raises. If you just have feeling connection and your Kundalini is awakened, you are initiated at least once in the physical presence, the necessity for being in the physical presence disappears wherever you are at this time. Connecting, you raise to this coherence and experience the intense spiritual awakening. Next thing I realized, if you go through the process of working on the tip of the nose, just now I discovered, see, the aging starts in your body, the tip of the nose. Every day, for example, you are now one day older than yesterday. So how that one day becoming older spreads to your biomemory? First, your tip of the nose becomes old. Oh, one moment old. Then that message goes to all the system, all over the system. Then all of them say, yes, now we are one moment old. Now we are 2 moment old, 3 moment old, 4 moment old, 5 moment old, 1 day old, 1 year old. So the first part which perceives aging in your body is tip of the nose. So if you put your awareness on the tip and unclutch from kala, time, the process which we did in the inner awakening, if you are initiated into that process, you are not even bound by this time. Whenever, wherever you want to sit, sit and connect, you will see awakening. You will see your frequency raising to this coherence and Kundalini experience happening. Understand? If you are just initiated into unclutching your Kundalini is awakened even once, you don't need to have experienced shaking of the body and rolling and all that. If you experience that, then it becomes foolproof, over. Even if you have not experienced those things, if you are initiated, if you had the energy experience during the initiation, see, there is a group and they come near me, intense experience, their body can't stand and jumps, rolls, does everything, but where they are sitting there, they may not have levitation. Understand? You are also already initiated. Even if you have that initiation, wherever you sit, you are now free from space. Wherever you sit at this time, that morning, when the Pratyaksha Pada Puja is happening, as on now it is 7:30 to 8:15, the Indian Standard Time. Sit wherever you are and connect. You will see the awakening. Nothing else is required. Nothing else is required. You don't need to do that chaotic breathing. You don't need to do the humming. You don't need to put the awareness. You don't need to unclutch. All the four, I am doing it at a time. See. So you don't need to do all this individually, independently. All 45 minutes, all the five process I am doing at a time. In Nitya Dhyan, what? What are the five process? Chaotic breathing, humming, putting your awareness on energy centers and awakening Kundalini, and Guru Puja. Is it not? Unclutching and Guru Puja. These five. All these five in Nitya Dhyan happens 7 minutes. Here the whole 45 minutes, all five at a time happens. Your Kundalini is awake. You are already doing chaotic breathing. And you are doing Guru Puja and what not. Understand? Just this 45 minutes. If you are initiated, you are free from space wherever you sit. Just sit. Don't miss. Don't miss. Just sit. Towards the direction of where Swamiji is residing. And connect. You will fall into that. You will raise into that coherence. And experience the Kundalini. In Yoga Sutras, we have a process called Samyama. Samyama means Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, all three put together. That is what I mean exactly unclutching. If you bring your awareness to the tip of the nose and unclutch from the passing time, the boredom created by time, excitement about expectations of time, the times may happen, and the negativity you carry about the times which had happened, unclutch from that. You are now free from time. So you don't even need to sit in particular time with me, to be with me, wherever you are. Just connect. I'll be there and you'll be there. We will be there. Together. If you are initiated into unclutching, you are free from space. If you are initiated into the unclutching from time, you are free from time. wherever you sit, whatever time it may be, just feel connected. Immediately you will see you raise to the coherence and you are experiencing N effect. I could see clearly today morning. I saw this whole area is in such high frequency coherence. You guys do not know how much you are contributing to the world peace just by sitting and unclutching in the Master's presence. I could see like a whirlpool that N effect happening and swallowing and destroying negativity. We are the black hole of negativity and big bang of N effect. I could see very clearly morning, wherever people are sitting and connecting, just that same N effect happening like a energy race, especially where my form is represented through photograph or murtis or padukas. Those energy centers just lit up. I could see cosmic lighthouses. Please understand how in the ocean, if the boats are lost, they see the lighthouse and reach the shore safely where they need to reach. I could see the souls which are lost in the cosmic darkness. The moment they see these lighthouses, they land in those houses or in those area and continue their spiritual journey. I myself used Arunachala as the lighthouse to land, to do what I want to do. I could see very clearly the N effect happening beautifully around the world. Understand? When the N effect happens in one body, it is awakening of the Kundalini and non-mechanical parts of the brains are awakened. Brain is awakened. If few people sit together, the same raising of the highest frequency and coherence happens, that is creating the N effect on the group. Group meditation, satsang. If a group sits in a city and creates the same N effect continuously at particular time for specific days, the N effect is created on the very city. And if a group sits, different groups sits in different parts of the world and create the same highest coherence at same time every day, the N effect is created on the planet Earth. Seekers, rishis, munis, gandharvas, yakshas, they all also join us in the same time, sitting in their places and connecting. It creates an effect on the whole universe because it is time to create Satya Yuga. Let's enter into the sutra, what Patanjali has to tell. It is 83rd sutra, in 2nd chapter, 32nd verse. Saucha santosha tapa swadhyaya ishvara pranidanani niyamaha. Swami Vivekananda translates this sutra as internal and external purification, contentment, mortification, study and worship of God are the niyamas. Swami Prabhavananda translates as the niyamas are purity, contentment, mortification, study and devotion to God. Sachidananda translates as niyama consists of purity, contentment, accepting but not causing pain, study of spiritual books and worship of God. Let me give my experience on this sutra. Saucha, santosha, tapa, swadhyaya, ishvara pranidanani niyamaha. First understand the word niyama. Niyama means creating the highest possible coherence in your body. A man who can create the highest possible coherence in his body is enlightened. Who is trying to create highest possible coherence in his body is a seeker. Who has created the highest possible coherence in his body is enlightened. Who can create that same effect of highest possible coherence in few people is an enlightened mystic. Who can create the same highest possible coherence in more people, but with practice, training and the sadhana, is an enlightened master, person who can create the highest possible coherence in his body, in any number of bodies, just by is an incarnation. Highest possible coherence being created in any number of bodies by the presence, nothing else, is called incarnation. The coherence is niyamaha. Niyama means coherence. All I am trying to do is creating coherence in more and more number of bodies. Not only that, creating bodies which can create coherence in other bodies. Niyama means creating highest possible coherence. Here Patanjali gives a very powerful technique to create highest possible coherence in you, in the community you are living, in the society you are living, and ultimately in the whole civilization you are living. Saucha, internal and external purity. If you are pure internally and externally, you will create coherence in your body. Santosha, happiness, bliss. If you are carrying that blissful body language continuously, you will create the highest possible coherence in the community you are living, in your workplace, in your house, wherever you are. Tapaha, ability to stand any persecution. Understand, persecuted man has a strength and juice which no ordinary man can have. Only if you are creating, people may go after you, try to persecute you. Understand, in political field, how many people you destroy, how much you can charge, that is your power. In spiritual field, how much you can stand, that is your power. Tapaha, if you have the tremendous ability to stand this persecution, the very civilization, society in which you are, you can transform. You can put the whole society into the highest possible coherence. Understand, through my tapas of accepting but not causing pain, millions of seekers around the world are raising and connecting with me. So I am transforming the very community in which I am living by this tapas, bearing, accepting and not causing pain. Tapas. If you have tapas, accepting all the suffering without questioning, suddenly you transform the whole community in which you are living. Understand? If you have saucha, inner and outer purity, you put your whole body into the highest possible coherence. If you have santosha, bliss, you put the community in which you are living into the highest possible coherence. If you have tapa means bearing, accepting the pain but not causing, the whole society in which you are living, you will put the whole society in highest possible coherence. If you have swadhyaya, constant strengthening of your highest ideas, highest ideals, you will put the whole civilization in which you are into the highest possible coherence. Ultimately, if you have Ishwara Pranidhana, surrendering to the ultimate, you will put the whole universe into the highest possible coherence. Understand? Niyama means raising yourself to the highest possible coherence. Through these five techniques, Saucha, Santosha, Tapas, Swadhyaya, Ishwara Pranidhanani, through these five, you can put your body, the community in which you are living, the society in which you are living, the civilization in which you are living, the whole universe in which you are living, to the highest possible coherence. Never miss even one possibility or a chance to be in the Master's presence. Of course, now in the modern day, please understand, in those days the physical presence is only called as presence. Now I declare, as I am the incarnation of the IT age, the virtual presence is equal to the physical presence. So wherever people sit with me virtually, with this two-way communication, I am able to see you all, you are able to see me. The physical presence happens. The yin effect happens with the same intensity. In the modern day, the incarnations have to update the capacity and ability and the possibilities through which the experiences are shared. When your senses are ripened, not only the extraordinary powers express, the tremendous transformation expresses through it. The character you show is a solid, unimaginable, amazing, divine, spiritual leela. the grace you radiate. The joy with which you handle life. Even the abusal done to you, the grace with which you walk out will be unimaginable. So, the yen effect is the powerful experience through which tapasaha and siddhi means boiling and ripening of your body and senses happens. Apart from that, the tremendous character, powerful character you express happens through the sense organs. Next question. This is Prasanna from San Jose. Is he there? San Jose? Prasanna? In many big festivals and religious gatherings, I have witnessed a handful of people start swaying and having involuntary motions. Never levitation, of course. My understanding was that for those few moments, they were possessed by God and were channels of the divine. Is my understanding correct? Prasanna, I don't want to say it is correct or wrong. It depends on individual. If the person who is swaying, having involuntary motions, if he is in bliss during the experience, and after the experience, if he becomes intelligent, Sat Chit Ananda. Sat means more integrated and more clear, more knowledgeable about life, death, and the great secrets of life. Okay. Having more understanding about sacred secrets. That's the first scale. Second, he should become more aware about his life and others' life. Third, he should become more blissful. If these three things, Sat, Chit, Ananda, is increasing in that person, then he is possessed by God for those few moments. If that three is not increasing, during the experience he is not blissful, and Sat Chit Ananda is not increasing after the experience, then it is not, he is not possessed by divine, he is just having some nervous breakdown. His nadi is having some chaotic experience. What is the difference between what we are experiencing during N effect and their experience? Please understand, Prasanna, this is the difference. If Sat Chit Ananda increases during the effect and after the effect, you are having N effect, Kundalini awakening. If that three is not there during the effect and after the effect, then it is nervous breakdown. So you can have, this is the right scale. Not to have the fake experience, fake levitation, nervous breakdown. Sit in Samana Mudra and Bhatmasana. You can never have fake experience. Those people who are swaying in these religious ceremonies and large gatherings, tell them to sit in Bhatmasana and Samana Mudra, everything will stop. Real Kundalini awakening only can move your body if you sit in Bhatmasana and Samana Mudra. If you are sitting in any other postures and body is swaying, moving, there can be doubt. But if you are sitting in Padmasana and Samana Mudra, any movement can be only out of Kundalini. So this is the scale to find out whether it is a nervous breakdown or an affect.
To inner awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.